Most of us are used to setting alarms on our phones to wake us up at specific times each morning. Typically, we position our phones so that they're always within arm's reach, like on the nightstand beside us. Seems normal, right? Well, have you ever stopped to ponder how much radiation exposure you're inviting into your life by keeping your phone next to your bed or your head every night, or in your pocket whenever you're out and about? All phones emit radiation, a fact that not everyone is aware of, the intensity of which may vary widely between different phone models. The reason behind this emission is that, unlike wired phones, wireless ones, like those widely used today, utilize radiation to relay signals. A question to therefore consider is, if you switch off the mobile data and Wi-Fi on your phone, would it significantly reduce the radiation to which you're exposed? To arrive at an answer, let's first explore what radiation is and how it functions. When we talk about radiation in this context, we refer to the electromagnetic kind. To illustrate, think about throwing a pebble into a lake. The force causes ripples that spread out far and wide. Similarly, an object like a smartphone, laptop, Wi-Fi router, or any device that operates wirelessly will also radiate waves all around it, much like the ripples filling the lake. However, these are not merely waves, they also transport energy. Electromagnetic radiation is not a novelty and is a constant presence around us. The fact that you're able to read this very text is due to visible light, another variant of electromagnetic radiation whose wavelength resides within the visible range. While it may be common for people to instantly associate the word radiation with danger, that isn't entirely accurate. There are two types of radiation, non-ionizing and ionizing. Non-ionizing radiation, like radio waves, are low energy and usually do not pose a threat to living organisms. They are generally not considered harmful to humans. In contrast, ionizing radiation, like gamma rays and X-rays, are energy-rich and can wreak havoc on the cells of plants, animals, and humans. Remember, smartphones use radio waves to communicate with nearby towers and electronic devices. As mentioned, radio waves, being non-ionizing, don't have the power to inflict major molecular changes in the human body. That said, it must also be pointed out that this is an area of ongoing research. There are also a number of studies that discuss the potentially harmful effects of prolonged exposure to non-ionizing radiation emitted by smartphones. Now, to use the internet on your phone, you need a wireless network connection. So turning off your Wi-Fi or mobile data, i.e. activating airplane mode, will expose you to less radiation. That said, your radiation exposure won't be altogether eliminated, as your mobile phone, even in standby mode, needs to remain online and ready to handle calls and messages, which require a connection to a nearby cell tower. Complementary features like Bluetooth also release radiation to connect with other nearby devices, such as headphones, speakers, and TVs. In other words, in our tech-reliant age, the complete elimination of exposure to phone radiation is unattainable. Therefore, it makes sense to shield our bodies from undue exposure. For instance, you can hold the phone away from your head during a call, switch your phone data and Wi-Fi off when it's not needed, and carry your phone in a bag rather than a pocket. All of these strategies can work wonders to significantly reduce radiation exposure. Admittedly, setting your phone on airplane mode all night might seem like a drastic move, but it isn't all that extreme and could help cut down on your daily radiation exposure.